throwing around names and accusations, but Check the Star. If you're listening, you slimy little bastard, if you're listening, I think you know exactly whose number that is. I think you know exactly whose number that is. And whoever's number that is, I think you might even introduce them to Aaron. And I feel like you got blood on your hands. I can't prove anything. I'm not accusing you of anything. But I feel in my intuition that you got blood on your hands, you slimy little fucking prick. And here's the thing too, what you guys need to understand, right? When I'm saying someone has blood on their hands, or when I'm saying that there's foul play, I am not using the word murder. I've never once said that I thought Aaron was murdered. I don't know what Aaron was, okay? But what I do know, from what I do know, is that there was foul play. And you don't have to be a rocket scientist. You don't have to be a detective on the fucking police force for the last 30 years. You don't have to be any of these things to fucking see that. And I believe that Check knows more than he's saying that he knows. I think he's scared to death. And I think he made a really bad decision because he wanted to be famous so fucking bad. And guess what? Sometimes in life when you make mistakes, you gotta pay for your mistakes. Sometimes you just can't sweep them. Sometimes they come back and they bite you in the ass. And I think that there were some mistakes made. And I think everybody needs to ask Check because of his inconsistencies. Just like he jumped on Rocky's Live and pretended he didn't know who the guy was in the video. But then he's like, then when they said that's him, they're like, ah, oh, he's like, nah, that's not him. The fuck? What do you mean? No, that's not him. You just said you didn't even know who that guy's, never seen him a day in your life. But then when they said, no, that's him, you're like, nah, bro, that's not him. What do you mean that's not him? You must know who he is to know that that's not him. Like, come on, bro. Everybody's catching these things. You'd be better off just shutting your fucking mouth and logging off the internet and stop worrying about this little clout chase that you're on, man. You tried to make Aaron your way into fame, man. No matter what way you want to look at it, Aaron is a sacrifice for you. And I'm not saying like you sacrificed him on some like murder shit or like you're the killer of Aaron. That's not what I'm saying or accusing you of. But what I'm saying is because of Aaron's death, because we lost Aaron, that opened up this little slimy little door for you to get millions of views on Worldstar, which is what you were after the whole time. And for you to try to act like you're this beautiful person that Aaron was in love with. Aaron was scared of Check. Aaron was very nervous around Check. Aaron might have been like fucking really fucked up on different prescriptions and his mental state and his mental health. But man, Aaron was not stupid, man. He knew people. He knew how to read people because he's had people like Check surrounding him his whole life trying to feed off him. So he could recognize that shit pretty easily. And Aaron was fucking nervous to Check. He wanted Check away from him. You know, and that's from his own mouth. So, you know, it's like he knew what that was, man. He rejected Check right off the bat. But I, regardless of any of that shit, I believe that Check knows exactly whose phone number that is. That's what I believe, Check. You know exactly who that number is, in my belief. And we're going to find out, Check. Trust me, we're going to find out. We're going to find out, Check. There's something slimy about you. Everybody can smell it, man. Anybody with a nose can smell shit. You know what I'm saying? We're going to find out, brother. We're going to find out, Miguel. You better start hitting the weights, Miguel. That's all I can tell you. Because you hit LA County Jail, boy. Fuck. God help you, man. God save you, man. You better start hitting the weights, boy. Because I think that you know some shit that's going to get you in trouble. And when I'm saying a foul play, you guys, like, keep in mind, like, I'm not saying, like, you know, like, people just go to the extremes. It's either Aaron just fell asleep in the tub because he's a fucking junkie, or he was murdered. You know what I'm saying? You guys got to realize life's not black and white. Sometimes it's somewhere weird in between that you can't even imagine. And, like, personally, if you guys want to know my personal theory, and this is just my theory, like I said, I don't know for a fact. I wasn't there. Who knows? Maybe I'll never know. I just know what my intuition's telling me and what my common sense is telling me. And when I'm putting together the facts and looking at things, my personal theory is that somebody was with Aaron prior to his death, probably sitting in the truck with them. That's why the window was down. That's why the smokes were out. That's why the ashtray had shit in it. They're probably sitting there either smoking a joint or smoking cigarettes. This person probably sold Aaron some illegal drugs. Aaron might have taken them right then and there with the person, been hanging out. Aaron may have possibly overdosed on whatever this person gave him. This person got nervous, put him in the bathtub, tried to make it look like it was an accident. They might not even meant for it to happen. It might have literally just been purely an accident. These things happen every single day. People overdose off shit every single day on the streets, man. It only takes one fucking little piece of sand of fentanyl to send you right up into the afterlife. And that's my theory. I don't think it was like, so, you know, I don't know. That's just a theory that I'm thinking when I'm looking at the facts. I think he was hanging out with somebody. That person gave him the drugs. Bad reaction. Person got scared, tried to cover it up. Because they knew that they were going to go to jail for fucking manslaughter or whatever the case may be, because they just gave this person fucking drugs that killed them. That's what would make the most sense to me. But then there's still a gang of other shit out there that does not make sense. Like this housekeeper. This is what you guys need to ask. This is what the question that you guys need to start asking, okay? I've been asking questions. I'm not getting no answers. Maybe you guys need to start using your voices and asking questions. Let me give you guys a list of what we need to ask. First of all, whose phone number is that Aaron, the last person that Aaron was in contact with that he was texting, whose phone number is that? Who is that? That's question number one. Like right off the top, like top of the list, question number one. Whose phone number was that? And who was Aaron talking to last on his private phone that was found in his Cadillac Escalade? Who's that? Second question we need to ask. Who is the housekeeper and who brought her to Aaron? Everyone's like, oh, it's just a homeless woman that moved in and they're helping her. Who brought her to Aaron? Who suggested that it would be a good idea to take in this woman off the streets and bring him into the home? And for what reason? Why were they brought in? What, you think Aaron was just the type of guy that would just go drive down Figueroa and fucking find a homeless person and move them into his fucking house? Someone that he trusts suggested that shit, or else he would have never, ever let somebody just move into his house who he didn't know at all to be the full-time live-in fucking housekeeper, especially if she was homeless. He would have been a little bit skeptical of her, okay? So somebody he clearly trusted told him that it would be a good idea for this woman to work for him. Who told him that? Who connected Aaron with that housekeeper? Where is the housekeeper now? Nobody's heard from the housekeeper since it happened. Why didn't the housekeeper let the police in the house? These are the two main questions that we need to ask right now. Forget all the other shit. Forget all the Sony shit. Forget all the stuff that you guys would call a conspiracy. Let's forget all that. Let's just start right there. That's where I want to start. First of all, whose fucking phone number is that? And why haven't the police figured that out? Or why are they not interested in that? Or why aren't they on that? Okay. And who's the housekeeper? And who brought her around? And where is she now? And why hasn't she answered any questions? Why hasn't she answered Melanie? Why didn't she answer Melanie for the 24 hours while all this was going on? She answered Melanie all the time for everything, no matter what, in the like 3 weeks that she was around prior to that. Why did she get no response the whole time that Aaron was missing from this woman and hasn't seen the woman since and hasn't heard from the woman since? Once you guys give me the answer to those questions, then I'll shut up a little bit and I'll fucking like, you know what I mean? I'll sit back and shut my mouth and stop talking about this. But until I get those two answers, Because I got a gang of other questions too, but I want to start right there. I want to start with whose fucking phone number is that? And I think Check knows. I think he can help us all out. And I think he knows whose phone number that is. And after we get that information, we need to know who that woman was. And we need to know if she has any connection to the person with the phone number. See, these are the things you need to look at. Okay? Like, fuck, man. Like, It's so fucking like obvious, like to start there. Okay. Why don't we have a toxicology report? If it was anything normal, If it was anything normal, it would have come back in fucking right away. Do you know how many people over?